Monday night, and as conspicuous by his absence is Mr. Matthew Rayner. So, you know me, you know this beautiful woman to my right.
Tamara, hey guys.
Alrighty, so we're gonna kick it off today, but I'm kind of upset Matt's not here. Matt was a little slow getting back from Outer Banks. I gave him some extra time, but we had a backup plan just in case he was hanging out. So we're good. We're here.
Plan.
We're live. Live and everything's good. How was your weekend?
It was good. I had a lovely weekend. I went to a baby shower and now I'm here partying. And guys, if you're here, either share the video or like it or show us some love. Do some hearts. Show us that you're here.
Just do some hearts and share the video. Share the video. Send it out to everybody. Let's get as many people in here as we can. It's going to be a good one. So obviously we had a real good show on Friday. It was a lot of fun. We talked about Big Bird, and we found out that Big Bird actually was transsexual. So that was what we found out over the weekend. So Big Bird is trans. So we didn't know if he was a man or a woman. It turns out he's neither. So
he's a bird.
He's a bird. If you hadn't seen it yet, The Final Destination, Big Bird is up in the shop. So feel free to go up and grab that. And you good? You good over there? All right. So it looks like you have some fans coming in there saying hey. So
hey,
Anissa.
Thanks for coming. I'm Anissa.
Anissa. So thank you for joining us, Anissa. Welcome to the show. And we're going to talk about a couple things today before we start. So first of all, as always, you know what? Before we get to the fan of the week, let's talk about the Pants Optional podcast. So we're going to be starting a podcast soon. So a lot of people were asking about it, and Amada and I were talking about it, and Matt obviously jumped in on it, and we're going to be doing some podcasting. So if he ever comes back. So yeah. I talked to Anna Rose, one of our fans of the show, and she's looking at launching a podcast too. So maybe we'll do some cross promotion, interviews, stuff like that. So
it's great to hear together.
But we're gonna do the podcast is gonna launch. It's gonna be a lot of fun. It's gonna be probably an extra hour of content for the week. So. Figure it might be pretty cool. So that'll launch in September. And then as far as the fan of the week, let's roll the intro for fan of the week. All right. So this week's fan of the show is a guy named, I believe it's Dewan.
Dewan. Mormon.
So Dewan was a fan of the show, and he actually asked us. We said, "Hey, you know, let us know how we can help you." And he said, "Okay." So that was it. That was it. So Dewan, I guess we helped you. I guess he didn't have any questions.
Here, yeah. If you're here, Dewan, say hi.
Yeah, I guess we got you already. I guess you're good. Because you didn't ask any follow up, so I mean, I guess you're pretty good. So you're a fan of the show. So give it up for Dewan, fan of the show right there. And, you know, let us know how we can help you. Okay, you know, easy peasy lemon squeezy. So
we have a lot to, you know, we can offer for help. So whatever you need, we got you.
We got you. We're in there.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
So give it up for Dewan. He's the fan of the week, and let's. You know, I'm ready to get into the game. Are you ready to get in the game?
Let's get into the game.
All right, let's throw out the rules. So we always throw out the rules. We always start it out. So each question is going to be asked two times. There's 15 questions. Once the question is asked, you have 20 seconds to respond in the chat. The first 12 questions are worth 1 point. The last three questions are worth 2 points. So they're a little harder. They might be a little more tricky. But they're there for a reason. So,
you guys know... If you don't know the answer, throw us out any fun answer, and you can get a point.
Yeah, emojis get points. So creativity wins this game. It doesn't necessarily have to be the right answer. The right answer will get you points, but a great answer will get you points too. So make sure you just throw out whatever you think the answer is. Answer every question, even if you don't know what it is and think it sounds stupid. I bet it doesn't, and
you'll get a point.
You get a point. Yeah. Amada, I just want to tell you, you look wonderful today.
Thank you. Look,
your skin is glowing. It's
thank you.
You're very
and
bronze.
We match today.
We do.
Thank you.
We do. We're in black.
You're wearing collared black, and I'm you know dressed up. We finally did it.
We finally aligned. So it's we're kind of like emo kids right now.
Yay!
I'm gonna grow up my hair and dye it black, and it's gonna be like classy 2005 all over again. So
yes.
All right. Well, let's get it started. So without any further ado, everybody. Here comes question number one. Question numero uno. In 2006, five 100-year-old crates of McKinley whiskey were discovered perfectly preserved in this location. In 2006, five 100-year-old crates of McKinley whiskey were found discovered perfectly preserved in this location. I don't know why I'm having so much trouble reading today, but
it's me.
It is. I'm flustered.
We switched spots.
I'm plus.
No, but remember, I was like half moron on Friday, and I'm like, baby.
That's true.
Hopefully, I can do good today.
But you were the one, you did a little day drinking today. I can respect it.
I did. But it'll be good.
I wish
I had some of this 100-year-old whiskey.
Right?
This is amazing.
This is where Matt, I was waiting for Matt to be here for this question, and he's not here. And he's a whiskey fan, so.
Tennessee is a good answer.
Coming in.
Yes.
I got my basement.
My basement.
That's a good answer.
That's a good one.
That's a good answer. Tennessee. So.
But it ain't it, guys.
It ain't it.
It's not the answer.
Was Anissa day drinking with you today?
Yeah, we had a few beverages together.
Yeah, that's all good. I'm glad you guys. Yeah. I'm glad you guys.
It was nice. It was hot. It was perfect. And that's what I need before the winter comes is like a hot day drinking day. So it was perfect.
I feel that. So
many Tennessees, guys.
A lot of people saying Tennessee. Kelly said Ireland. It's a good guess. You know,
yeah,
Alex
yeah.
said my basement. It's a good guess, but I hate to do it so early in the show on question one.
No,
but we got to do it. Three, two, one. So these five 100-year-old crates of McKinley whiskey were discovered perfectly preserved in Antarctica. So they were frozen, and they were on ice.
That's
and they,
why
were found,
they were perfectly preserved.
They were perfectly preserved for 100 years. So some
Nobody
all the whiskey
it.
Drinkers out there, that's some value. So
yeah.
So I'm all about value. And on that note, hopefully question number two takes it to a better place. I feel good about question number two. You feel good about question two?
I'm feeling anything Disney. I'm good. So
all right, let's do it.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
When the CIA released the contents of Osama bin Laden's compound, the only DVD that was found was this forgotten Disney film from the early 2000s. I like this.
Me too.
I thought it was cute.
Me too. I it's one of my favorites, actually. So, you know, back in my old, when I was working at Best Buy, I used to show this. This was like the first Blu-ray that came out. So it looked we used to play this on loop and it looked so realistic and people would be like, I need to buy a $5,000 TV and now you could probably buy it for $2.99. So but
dang, that's good.
But I was a fan. I enjoyed it. So I'm
yeah.
Go ahead.
The irony of it being this was in there because the world is ending, right? In this movie.
Yeah.
So that's pretty ironic. We don't have anybody coming in.
I don't think any answers coming in. So got the rescuers from Anna Rose. I hope we didn't make these too hard today. I feel like we
Meet the Robinsons.
I like Meet the Robinsons. Yeah. That was a good movie. But
that was a good
not
movie.
The right one. I'm a big fan of the actor who played the main character, Zach Braff from Scrubs.
Oh yeah.
He did the voice of the main character.
Cute.
So I got Alex in Armageddon. So man, this is killing
guys.
Me today. I think Ed might have just made it a salvageable question. So I don't feel so bad anymore.
Have the air hornet.
What is the correct answer, Amada?
It's Chicken Little.
Chicken Little. So there's a picture of Osama bin Laden holding his copy of Chicken Little. You know, I definitely didn't Photoshop that myself, but he was carrying a copy of Chicken Little. That was the only DVD that was found inside his compound. So
well, it's a great movie. What are you gonna do?
I was a huge fan. So
yeah,
it was the Bare Naked Ladies did the theme song to that. Remember them?
Yeah, I never knew that. That's awesome.
Just so you know, one day it'll probably come up on the show, but I can definitely do the entire Chickity China the Chinese Chicken verse in karaoke.
Oh, I'm sure you can. So. You are the karaoke king.
You already know.
So, yes, I do. Y'all don't even know.
Mm. Let's take another question.
We'll save that for another show.
It'll be the spin-off of the podcast. We'll have a karaoke podcast. Yeah, yeah. Question number three. So I'm hoping everybody gets in here. I'm sorry these are so hard today. A 17-year-old Mexico City boy died in 2016 from a stroke after his girlfriend gave him one of these. A 17-year-old Mexico City boy died in 2016 from a stroke after his girlfriend gave him one of these.
That is so weird.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is the last thing I would have thought.
So you think this one's hard too? You think anybody's going to get it?
I don't know. I would definitely think of something else, you know, like girlfriend gave him one of these. I would definitely think not. See, yeah, like Amanda said, blowy. Like you would think that that was it, but that's not.
Right.
No.
Blowy. So Blumpkin.
What's a Blumpkin?
Kelly, why don't you explain what a Blumpkin is? I'll put it up on the screen. I know what it is, but I want you to take this opportunity. So maybe you could be a fan of the show. But I have Alex saying reach around. Anissa saying a surprise party. Ed saying a handy. Dave saying a blowjob. Kathy saying a Red Bull. All good guesses.
Yeah.
All good guesses.
But not, that ain't
not
it.
The right one. I didn't realize these were so tough today.
Wow, we're really making people think.
I know. Joanna says Benadryl. It looks like we might have gotten one answer in there.
Oh.
So it might be my daddy. So
might look be at that.
My dad. So the correct answer is a hickey. So that he had a blood clot that formed in his neck after a hickey.
She must have been sucking real hard.
Yeah, bro.
Jeez. So, okay, Dyson.
So Kelly, I'm waiting for your definition of Blumpkin so I can throw it up on the screen. But we'll go on to question four, and then we'll talk about Blumpkins, and then who the fuck is that guy? So question number four, take it away.
All right, Tupac Shakur secretly dated this pop icon and actually lived with her for 4 months until he dumped her in 1996 because he was scared of being hurt. Tupac Shakur secretly dated this pop icon and actually lived with her for 4 months until he dumped her in 1996 because he was scared of being hurt. Never knew this. Never would have guessed this.
Tupac, man. Tupac's got a heart. So
I mean, for this, I never knew. I'm shook. A beautiful variation of everyone's favorite answer, the blowy, possibly involving a toilet. Ew.
So at least,
ew!
Yeah, the Blumpkin. The blowy, while there's a Dumpkin taken. So it's a Blumpkin. It's a Blumpkin. It floats. So.
I'm so good on that.
So Kelly, thank you for providing us with that answer. I appreciate
Thanks,
that.
Thanks, Kelly.
You know, you might be a fan of the show next week because that's definitely a awesome thing. The other thing that Kelly did really well today is she got this answer right. So
yeah,
she got this answer right.
There's some good guesses going.
There are some good guesses going. So yeah. I got Bruce in there as well. And Mata, what's the answer?
It's Madonna.
Your girl Madonna. So Madonna and Tupac were actually dating right before Tupac died. And
conspiracies.
Yeah. So Tupac said he was afraid of being hurt. He wrote her a letter, and it went to auction. So somebody bought the letter that he wrote to Madonna saying he was afraid of being hurt. Tupac, the most gangster man in the world, was afraid of being hurt. So
it's, I mean, women do that, so.
Women are brutal. You know what else is brutal? You know what else is brutal?
Tell me.
Who the fuck is that guy?
All right, so who the fuck is that guy this week? And I think this one, I'm not trying to toot my own horn, but I think I did a really good job with this one. I think this like is actually art quality. This might be museum quality. So
yeah,
if you think it is, feel free to let me know. I love it, but I'm a fan. I'm a fan of the guy. So, without any further ado, I don't want to keep talking it up. Who the fuck is that guy?
So. You know, when I first saw it, I thought it was somebody else because it looks like somebody else. But it also looks like the picture that you drew it of.
Yeah.
So it's pretty great. I like it.
It is. I'm a fan of his works. He's done quite a bit.
Yeah.
I can't really talk about them because they kind of are synonymous with him.
Give it away.
They give it all away. But
mm-hmm.
I'm waiting to see.
Wasn't he a singer?
Oh, he's definitely a singer. Yeah. In Germany.
Okay.
In Germany.
Oh,
Germany.
Wow.
Huge in Germany.
Whoa. Huge, I didn't realize it was like that.
Huge in Germany. So, waiting to see if anybody comes
with the
right
answer.
Oh, my God.
The hair. Everything.
We got delayed today or something. I'm worried.
Either late or
nobody knows. Nobody knows who it is. So
John Travolta, that's a good one.
Travolta, good guess. So
yeah, that is a very good guess.
Right.
Wow.
So
people are really getting it off the bat. I would have never.
Yeah.
These are getting harder, guys.
I know.
You drawing them.
Well, you know, my drawing skills aren't exactly that, you know, anything to write home about, but.
Well. That's the point. That's the point of the whole thing, right?
I want somebody else to draw. I want to see some fan drawings one day. I want to see some fan.
Right.
I want to see a fan of the show draw in a picture. So.
And who the fuck is that guy? Yeah.
So
I agree.
We got a lot of people getting this one, so I'm glad. I'm glad that it was such a good picture. But the correct answer is your man David Hasselhoff of Baywatch, of Knight Rider, of. Everything
Stud.
Else, what he did, I don't know. Guardians of the Galaxy 2, he was in for like 3 seconds.
Did?
He was in there for
really?
Like 3 seconds. Remember, Star-Lord said he thought his dad looked like David Hasselhoff. So.
Oh my God.
Bruh.
Cool.
So.
Nice.
Knight Rider.
Love it. Love it.
Well, you know what I love? It's question number 6.
All right. Well, gorillas sing happier songs and at a higher volume when they're doing this. Gorillas and myself sing happier songs and at a higher volume when they were doing this. This is 100% me and gorillas.
Audrey says she'll get Cheyenne to draw some in anime. So Cheyenne, ooh. Cheyenne is quite the artist. It's quite the artiste.
And anime?
Maybe I can secure one of those drawings for Friday night's show. So maybe we'll get a anime version for who the fuck is that guy?
That sounds phenom.
I like it.
Sucking helium? That's a good one, but no.
I like it.
That ain't it.
That ain't it.
Mm-mm.
All right.
No, but, you know, saying... me singing happier songs and higher volume, that should give it away if you know anything about me.
Right. French fries.
Ooh,
at 3
we got
in the morning.
Some people.
What?
Yeah. Oh, nose candy. I didn't know gorillas did that.
No, but the correct answer, Amada,
is my favorite thing to do is eating.
Eating. So yeah. when gorillas are eating, they're happier, and they're singing happier songs. They sing all the time, but they're singing happier songs and louder when they're eating. So, means they're fed. So, we're gonna go on to question number 7. So, question number 7, I'm here for it. In 2017, a Saudi Arabian history textbook was recalled because editors accidentally used a Photoshop picture of King Faisal sitting with this Star Wars character. In 2017. A Saudi Arabian history textbook was recalled because editors accidentally used a Photoshop picture of King Faisal sitting with this Star Wars character.
So, can you imagine?
Imagine being a kid in like school and being like, is that real?
Has this been my whole life?
Is that legit? Is that legit? Because,
I mean,
it could be.
It could be.
Definitely could be. But
in 2017, too? Oh my gosh.
It's recent. I try to stick with some recent examples here, but
and in Saudi Arabia,
that's
hilarious.
Yeah, man,
that's a good prank.
Yeah, man. So
I got
a lot of people saying Chewbacca.
Oh.
Ed saying Kit Fisto.
Mm-hmm.
I had to gargle the water to do the Chewbacca noise.
That is perfect.
All right. I got Jabba, I got Darth Maul, I got Chewbacca, I got Chewbacca. Wow. A lot of people saying Chewbacca. I got a lot of people saying Chewbacca. Unfortunately, not the right answer. But I got Princess Leia, Jabba the Hutt, Darth Vader. I gotta drop it with Kathy, though. Drop it with Kathy.
Mama got it.
It's your homeboy, Yoda. And there's the picture on the screen right now, hanging out with King Faisal. This was actually published in these Saudi Arabian textbooks. So Yoda was hanging out with the king, and people were learning, and they were learning that this was legit. So Yoda chilling with the king. Chilling with the king, is he? So they got tricked. We got one more, and that's halftime. Take it away.
Judd Nelson, Alan Rickman, and Rick Moranis all turned down this role before a young man named Jim Carrey was cast. Judd Nelson, Alan Rickman, and Rick, am I saying that right? Moranis, all turned down this role before a young man named Jim Carrey was cast. That's crazy. Alan Rickman, I would have never guessed that he, like, what?
Do you know, so you don't know who Rick Moranis is? He's the guy from Honey, I Shrunk the Kids.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's not even like, Jim Carrey was the perfect. I could not see any of these other people doing this.
I don't think anybody else could have pulled it off quite as quite as well as JC did.
He is the movie.
He really is.
Yeah.
So I'm a huge fan. I will say this. If that movie was made today, there's no way it would get past censors. Like, there's no way that they would allow that to fly in today's world. So
I love that movie, though. Oh, or the movies.
It's yes, the movies, because there are two of them. And it's not Son of the Mask, because Son of the Mask was terrible. Did you see Son of the Mask?
No.
Jamie Kennedy?
I did not.
Don't.
No. Oh, yes, I did. Oh, Jamie Kennedy. Where the hell did he go?
Jamie Kennedy from Scream. He was in Scream. But the correct answer is...
Oh, it's a I was thinking about Jamie Kennedy in Malibu's Most Wanted.
Malibu's Most Wanted. Where did my Aston Tour video go? I had a video ready to play, too. And I don't know if we're going to get it. So
that's okay. We all know who he is.
We all know Ace Ventura. So I guess my video's slacking. My video skills slacking, but I apologize. Ace Ventura, Pet Detective, Ace Ventura, When Nature Calls. So Ace Ventura is the correct answer. Anissa came in with that one at the end. So we had a couple good answers with that one, but we're about to go into halftime. So halftime today is a video that Audrey actually sent me. She sent this one in. She wanted to share it. And so it's a sign language interpreter at a Lamb of God concert. So if you're familiar with Lamb of God, basically they're yelling out, "This next song, motherfucker," and she's up there doing the whole thing. So I'm gonna play it. You guys can watch. So here it comes.
Awesome.
So that was,
she's so aggressive.
She was in her zone, man. She was the interpreter for all the I can't imagine being at a metal concert and getting an interpreter, but that's cool, you know, to each their own. So
I love it.
We're gonna go on to question number 9. So Audrey says she couldn't imagine Alan Rickman as Ace Ventura. I couldn't either.
Me neither.
But
at all.
I can't picture anybody but Jim Carrey doing it, to be honest with you. He was perfect for that, so, and that kind of kickstarted his career. So,
yeah.
If we didn't have that, who knows? We might never had Dumb and Dumber. There's. So Anissa says, "Who is Alan Rickman?"
It's Severus Snape from Harry Potter. You know who he is, or he was in
Hans Gruber.
What?
Hans Gruber.
What's that?
From Die Hard.
Oh, okay. Sam, you're too old for me, man. I'm just kidding.
It's all right. That's the So, yeah, Alan Rickman, Severus Snape. So, let's go back to the game.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to go back to the game. So, question number nine. In this artist's 2011 music video for Spacebound, he argues with former porn star Sasha Grey and ends up graphically shooting himself with her gun. In this artist's 2011 music video for Spacebound, he argues with former porn star Sasha Grey and ends up graphically shooting himself with her gun. So, throw up the counter.
Way to go.
Hans Gruber.
That's what happens. What happens when you act up.
Yeah.
Karma. He's immediately.
Let's see what Matt's doing. Let's see if he's see if he wants to get in on this.
Is he... What's he doing? Is he still... Oh, that's a good one.
You still there?
Yeah.
All right.
She almost cut me off.
You didn't have to cut me off. All right.
Ooh, bringing that karaoke out. I love it.
So I got Kelly. I got Anissa. And I'm waiting to see if anybody else comes in with the correct answer. So I got Dave coming in with the right answer. So I got Joanne coming in with the right answer. We got Alex. Alex is bringing up a great question. Die Hard, Christmas movie or no?
Is it in Christmas time?
It is in Christmas time. It's in Nakatomi Plaza. I think it is. Wow. I say yes. So
I'm gonna have to watch this. Everybody needs to get me like a list of these movies that I need to watch because this keeps happening to me. That everybody's like, "Have you seen this?" And I'm like,
so, yeah, of course. I'm so behind on movies. But anyway, we're getting off track. But I'm so behind on movies. I haven't caught much. This track was from the man known as Marshall Mathers, Eminem. The song is called Spacebound, and he did a video with Sasha Grey, who was a former porn star. She used to be in our old Adults Only trivia intro for a while, but she's. You ever seen The Girlfriend Experience, that movie she was in? It was an interesting one. It was a mainstream Steven Soderbergh movie, but it was a good one.
Another thing I haven't seen.
That's all right. So, but do you know what time it is? It's time to take a step back a couple years, and we're taking a step back in history. So, without any further ado, let's take a step back.
So today in Dup history, on August 23rd, today, 1974, John Lennon claimed he was lying naked on his bed in a New York City hotel room when he got an urge to go out on his balcony and reportedly saw one of these. On August 23rd, 1974, John Lennon claimed he was lying naked on his bed in a New York City hotel room when he got an urge to go out on his balcony and reportedly saw one of these. Have you ever seen one of these?
No.
I think I have.
Do you? Really?
Yes.
Where?
I think that my grandparents had a bunch of land in Pennsylvania, mm-hmm. and me and my cousin were outside and saw, like, in the middle of the woods. There was just nobody around because we were, like, in the middle of nowhere. It was just this big ball of light, like, inside the wood. It was so weird.
Really?
Yeah.
That sounds it.
And I have read, now that I'm older, that this has happened to other people.
Really?
Creepy. Look at all these answers coming in.
I know. We got everybody coming in with this one, so.
Yeah, the Jersey Devil.
Jersey Devil.
It was in New York. It's close.
All right, let me just make sure I got everybody.
Flying saucer, bro.
I like that.
I love that.
I love it.
Does anybody, where are the UFO emojis, guys?
I know. We need some.
I know there is one.
I saw an alien emoji up top.
Oh, an alien,
top.
Yeah.
I saw an alien Same emoji thing. Up top, so.
Those are also unidentified flying objects.
So, yeah, the correct answer, UFO. So,
it's a UFO.
UFO. So, John Lennon, chilling. Chilling naked, I mean, saw a UFO coming. So
he was probably high as a kite. So
probably. So there it is. Nisa got it. Let me throw it up on the screen.
There we go.
That's what we needed. It. I'm gonna make it.
Kelly, thanks guys.
Thanks guys.
For bringing your emojis.
We appreciate that. So, all right, we're gonna go on to question number 11. Question number 11. According to ancient Greek texts, this mythical animal's burps are said to taste like freshly cut grass. According to ancient Greek texts, this mythical animal's burps are said to taste like freshly cut grass.
I'm here for it.
I'm here for it, too.
I love that.
Actually,
Florida grass that's being cut smells like shit, but the north grass smells amazing.
Well, it's because it's
incredible.
It's named after Florida.
And yeah.
We'll find out about that in about, you know, 30 seconds from now.
Yeah.
But
that's right.
But
anybody? Nobody has the answer to this, guys?
It's just guess. Mythical animals. Maybe it's
a mythical animal.
Bigfoot. Maybe it's a minotaur. I don't know.
Maybe it's a fairy.
Maybe it's a fairy.
Ooh, is a Pegasus also a unicorn? Oh, no, a Pegasus has wings. A unicorn does not.
Yeah, but I think that might count. So.
Yeah.
Anna Rose. Oh, there we go. Now everybody's coming in.
Wow, look at all these. All
right, I like it.
Yeah.
I like it. All right. So, I got Amanda, I got Nisa, I got everybody coming up there. The correct answer is
the unicorn.
Unicorn.
It's a unicorn.
Unicorn.
Oh, that was you.
That's all right. I don't care. That's
sorry.
It's all right. You didn't step on my toes. It's all right. I'm
unicorn.
I appreciate
our
you.
Favorite mythical.
But this is Alex's feature. Favorite segment, and I'm going to remember to play a video this time for the first time because usually I forget to play this video. So we're going to play it today.
You're doing great.
But I'm trying. But here we go. So this week in Florida.
This week in Florida.
Amada, tell me about what's going on in the wonderful world of Florida.
Ugh. This week, a Clearwater, Florida man stole 13 of these from a convenience store, then was arrested, returned to the same place to turn them in. This week, a Clearwater, Florida man stole 13 of these from a convenience store, then was arrested, returned to the same place to turn them in. What did he bring back?
I don't know if I did that in proper grammar. I think was arrested and he returned to the same place. But that's all right.
And then he returned. He was arrested.
He was arrested and then he returned to the same place.
To get his money.
Yeah, but Florida, you know.
Yeah.
It's not perfect. So.
I mean, I probably would have done the same.
That's...
You know that there's a method to the madness of these things. You have to buy five of them.
Really?
You have to buy so many of them because of the ratio. You have to pay attention to that ratio. And then you have to buy one more than it says. So every other, like, you'll at least win something.
Interesting.
Whether it be a new one or an actual prize.
All right. I'll take it.
Yeah.
So, looks like everybody's taking at least a stab at it. But
yeah.
I got Ed. I got Kat. All right, so the correct answer, and Rose in there, is
the scratch-off lottery ticket. I love those. I love the scratch-off.
Scratch-off lottery tickets. So,
yeah
we love the lottery tickets here. It's a staple of our, you know, economy in Florida.
Yeah.
It's all over the place.
Love it.
So, I'm looking at scores because you know what time it is. It's time for two-point questions. So,
two-point
questions are here. Now I'm looking at scores. I got Bruce with 6 points. I got Kelly with 6 points. I got Kathy with 5 points. I have Joanne with 4 points. I have Anna Rose with 6 points. Yeah, 6 points. I have Anissa with 5 points.
Okay, girl.
So there's it might come down to the tiebreaker today. But we had some toughies today, so I understand. But we're in the two-point questions. So, two-point questions. Question number 13. In 1887, the first ones of these were made. They were completely made of blown glass and thus could only be worn for a few hours because of their weight. So,
wow.
Yeah.
That is tough. But that's a long time ago to have such technology. I'm sure.
Right? That's what I'm saying.
I never even knew that. I thought this was definitely a 1900 techno thing. You know what I mean?
I'm with you.
I'm shook. I love it.
We'll see if anybody gets it.
But earrings.
I got earrings. Oh, earrings.
Two pieces of earrings?
It's a good guess. It's a good guess.
Oh, because of their weight. That makes sense. Yes.
Makes sense. Purse, earrings. A lot of people.
Oh, a lot of earrings.
A lot of people dropping the earrings in there. So
that ain't it, guys.
Necklace.
You're gonna be shocked when you hear it, just as I was.
Bras.
A diving helmet.
You know what? Glasses. She's close. She's close.
No cigar.
She's close. So I have to do it, guys. 3, 2, 1. The correct answer is contact lenses. So somebody made contact lenses that you could put in your eyes in 1887 out of blown glass. And
I wonder how many eyes were cut.
I can only imagine, like, I'm not even thinking that. Anissa got it. I think she got in right before the buzzer. So Anissa got
nice.
It. So she got in right before the buzzer, and that puts her in a multi-way. Actually, no, it puts her in the lead because that's a 2-point question. So Anissa is
first time winning.
Anissa started. She was out day drinking today. She might be the winner tonight. She could pull ahead and win.
That's right.
So let's see how she does.
I love these people coming in their first time winning this game. I love it.
I love it too. You'd love to see it.
Here for it.
Love to see it. Question,
love to see it.
Question number 14, Amada. Take it away.
In 1974, the British Medical Journal exposed a condition in which people who partook in this hobby reported chafing of the nipples. In 1974, the British Medical Journal exposed a condition in which people who partook in this hobby reported chafing of the nipples.
All right.
I could see it.
So I do this. I do this. This is something that I do.
I didn't know that. Really?
Really?
Do your nipples chafe?
Oh,
I knew that. You're right. I knew that. I'm stupid.
Really, bro?
I know. I knew that.
But
I was day drinking.
That's true. With Anissa.
Yeah.
I'm looking at. So, I can't see Anissa's picture, but she's kind of cute. What's up, Anissa? How you doing? You good?
Oh. Yes.
No, kidding. I'm kidding. I'm happily spoken for, but
everybody's happily spoken for. do you get chafing nipples?
No, I don't. So, a lot of people saying running, wrestling, sweating. You know, wrestling. That
breastfeeding is true.
Remember this, guys. I this is something that I do. It's something I personally do. So, I'm not trying.
So he doesn't breastfeed. Do you sweat or run?
I don't know. Do I?
Oh,
whoa.
Look at that guy.
Or do I? What is the answer?
It's the guitarist.
Yeah.
They have that up there, clapping the bass and chafe their nipples, guys.
Yeah. So the guitar actually will, the strap goes over the nipple. And they have, it's called guitarist nipple. It's an actual medical condition. So.
It's
kind of weird.
Oh my
right?
God!
Isn't that weird?
That is so weird.
Isn't that weird?
Guitarist nipple.
You learn a lot of stuff on this show. This is a awesome show. So,
education
for everybody. So, without any further ado, we're going to go on to question number 15. So, question number 15.
Last question.
And we'll see. But Anissa might win it right now. She might be the winner. So let's see. The French refer to this as le petit mort. Or the little death. The French refer to this as le petit mort. Or the little death.
I love that.
Le petit mort. Le petit mort.
Le petit mort. I love that.
Le petit mort.
You're supposed to pick the strings. What does that have to do with your nipples, though?
But it's not. It's the strap. It's the strap. Because you're doing the rocking thing. And it's like Linda Williams and Daywan Mormon is the little death. Alex, you know, it's,
Alex, one point at least.
At least 1 point for that. So we might give Alex a point for that. So we're going to give, I got Swiss roll. I got nap. Le petit mot. Twinkie.
Did Linda Williams ever know how big of a fan we are?
I don't know. For her? I don't know.
She's got to know.
I have to find that picture again. I should keep that over here just for forever. Yeah. Throw it up. So, fans of the show, Alex says, Kelly says nap.
A nap.
So,
I guess the little death, that could make sense.
Yeah. I'm waiting to see if anybody else comes in. This is kind of crazy.
A lot of naps. Everybody's napping.
A lot of naps. But the correct answer, I hate to do it. I guess we had extra hard questions this week. I didn't.
Yeah, we did.
I'm sorry, guys. You know, maybe we'll make them a little easier next time. 3, 2, 1. You hate to see it. But Kathy came in the end with it. And believe it or not, that puts Kathy into a tie with Anissa. So,
ooh.
Kathy is in a tie with Anissa. So,
we need the tiebreaker.
We might need the tiebreaker. So, we're going to see. But the correct answer was orgasm. So, le petit mot is what they call an orgasm in French. So,
wow.
It's kind of hot. So, le petit mot. Le petit mot. So, we're going to go on to the tiebreaker. The tiebreaker's a little vulgar. I'm not going to lie to you. It's a little vulgar. But we're going to try and throw it out there. I'm looking for answers from Kathy and Anissa. But everybody can answer. You all can throw whatever you think the answer is up there. And, you know, let's give it your best shot. The correct answer for this question. How many searches were made for Taylor Swift on Pornhub in 2019? How many searches were made for Taylor Swift on Pornhub in 2019? Bruce is saying he was in. You were in, but you only have 6 points. You only have 6 points. So you can answer the question if you want, but you only have six
Price
points.
Price is right.
Price is right rules. So how many searches were made for T-Swift?
In 2019. We should put Jeopardy music in at the end. I like that for the tiebreakers.
Dave says 30,000. That's a good guess.
Dave.
Audrey says 17,000.
17,000. I mean,
I need Kathy and Lisa here.
We're 10 million. Okay. 40 million. 5 million.
5 million and 10 million. So,
all right.
I would love to congratulate Anissa right now because she's my boo. After, you know, what's up? But but she's over. She's over. The correct answer is 1 million. Hold on. 1,793,415.
Yeah.
So Kathy is the winner today. So give her the claps. Give her the air horn. And listen, for research purposes, I had to go and find Taylor Swift on Pornhub. It's a little graphic. I edited it. But if you want to see what it looks like, somebody actually took, like a graphic editor, took Taylor Swift and superimposed her face on a porn star. So here goes. It's pretty realistic. It's pretty creepy. But this is about all I could get on there. You see us floating with our little our little mermaid. So Kathy is the winner, and Taylor Swift, big fan there. So so what's going on? I was trying to get Matt in here.
She's a nasty girl.
Matt said he's pooping, so he's not joining us.
Whatever, Matt.
Whatever, Matt.
See him Friday, I guess.
I guess. So I'll be in New Jersey, so it'll be pretty awesome.
Yeah.
But
maybe you guys can get together.
That would be awesome. So
maybe we could do the show.
I'm currently in the bathroom. This guy. So what do you got going on this week? Anything good?
You know, the job I work. And fun on Friday.
Fun on Friday.
Like our page. Go share our page.
Share the crap out of it. Send it to everybody. Send it to everybody you know.
Send it to everybody. Everybody you know. Let them know that you love to play our game and that they should come play too. Right?
Yeah. So that's I'm excited. I think it's gonna be a good week, and we'll have the midweek snack coming up on Wednesday. And then we have the Pants Optional podcast launching next month. So there's a lot of good stuff to look forward to.
Yeah.
But now you can go to bed. You can relax. You can go night night, and
party.
I'll probably do the same. So
woohoo!
I love you guys. Have a wonderful, wonderful week. Peace out.